Good morning, every viewers. Today's video is related to standard 9. In this video, we will concern over the Northern Plain, part 2. Part 1 is delivered during previous period, part 1 is taught during previous classes, previous views. In this video, we will concern over the Northern Plain that is the part of the physical features of India. First divisions was the northern mountain ranges. The second division is the northern plain. In this video, we will discuss about the Northern Plain. That is part of Northern Plain that we taught in previous videos. After that, this is the second part. Then, in this part, we will focus on the divisions of Northern Plain. There are 4 divisions of Northern Plain. They are Bhavar, Tarai, Bangar and Khadar. These are the four divisions of the Northern Plain. Generally, Northern Plain is considered as flat and it is flat land and with no variation. No variations are found in this plain, but it is not true because have diverse relief features also. Means India have diverse relief features also. Means the higher parts, the middle parts, the Bangar and the Khadar, these are the lower parts. Khadar are the lowermost parts of this plain, while Bhavar is the uppermost parts of this Northern Plain. So according to variation, this Northern Plain is divided by 4 regions. First region is Bhavar, that is the uppermost regions of this plain. Second is Tarai, and third is Bangar, and fourth is Khadar. Now, let us come on the first divisions of Bhavar. The Bhavar is the region. The rivers after descending from the mountainous, means the river which descending, which which rise from the mountainous parts. So they carried the pebbles and the bigger nodules of rock particles, and it is a narrow belt and about 8 to 16 kilometer width, which means breadth of this plain, this Bhavar in 8 to 16 kilometer and lying parallel to the slope of the Shivalik. Actually, the Shivalik range, after the Shivalik range, the southernmost parts of this region is considered as the Bhavar region. And in this region, where all these streams disappeared here. No any streams and rivers can have a stream, they become the river here. After that, the second is the Tarai. South of the Bhavar belt, streams and rivers re-emerge. Means the south of the Bhavar, where rivers and streams may re-emerge and create a wet, swampy and marshy region, which was thickly forested region. This is the swampy, and this was the deeply forested region where a lot of forests are found and are full of wildlife are contained here. So this is the totally forested regions of this of the country where a lot of forest trees, plant beings and animal beings lived here. And the forest have been cleared. Means after partition, when a lot of people that comes from Pakistan and as a refugee, so these peoples are settled in these regions, and due to settlement of these refugees and many others create a type of deforestation. They cutting down the forest and trees and clear the patch of this land and make them fields where the agricultural activities done very efficiently. So and many migrants settled in these regions after partition, when a lot of refugees came from Pakistan that came in this region and settled here, and due to their settlement this forest of these regions became cleared, and this is the and cleared, and this become not fully forested region for the country. Do you know that Dudhwa National Park, which situated in this Tarai region also. After that, Tarai, after that, the Bangar is the regions which are consisted of old alluvium. Means the alluvium, the pebbles, the fine particles that carried by the river in older situation, in primary situation in the country. So where above the flood plain where these pebbles, these depositions carried by the river and create a terrace like structure. Terrace means siri numa. Terrace like structure create and present here. And the soil on this region contains calcareous deposits, which called kankar nodules, and these are found abundantly in this soil. Apart from this, that the khadar is the next part of this northern plain, and the newer younger deposits of the flood plain. Actually, newer and younger deposits of soil that have very fertile soil that have consisted of a lot of fertility and a lot of humus are also contained in this soil. So it is very very fertile, and this is the floodplain area and different rivers carried a flood in both marginal parts of the region. So they deposited the newer soil contain each and every year, because in August period, in the August month, where these rivers brought a flood, in flood many people lost their animals, lost their properties, but they get newer soil every year, and this due to deposition of this newer soil every year, and the fertility of the soil maintained here, and it become ideal for intensive agriculture. And due to intensive agriculture, these areas have full of densely population, and this areas become densely populated areas. Fortunately, your district Khagaria is belong to this other regions of the northern plain. So viewers already, and I think you will understand these terms of this plain, northern plains, and which are very very important for the country, which are very very important for the national economy also. Okay, so this video is finished. In next video, we will discuss about the peninsular plateaus and other parts of the country. Okay, thank you very much.